You may have heard about this 10 seconds video artwork, which was sold for $6.6 million last year. NFT sales, in fact, topped $4 billion just last month. But it's not just NFTs or digital arts that have got investors' attention. Virtual experiences like going to a sports game with your friends, that's becoming the next frontier in this technology. Let's get into some details. Metaverse sounds like something that came from a science fiction. Back in the early 90s, people were unsure of how the internet was going to be. Back then, internet was originally called the Information Superhighway. Later, they changed it to just the internet. And today, people can access the internet pretty much anywhere. Metaverse basically uses the same internet that will allow people to connect online and interact with the other people. Now, that sounds like any social media such as Facebook or WhatsApp, because you can just chat or do video calls with the other person, but that's where the metaverse is trying to change and improve upon. So what makes the metaverse different from other online socialization services? Metaverse allows people to give them customization and features that social media sites don't have. We are talking about virtual reality immersion. That's right, VR technology could be the future of the metaverse. Just picture yourself in a virtual world interacting with people. Metaverse will allow people to go into specific digital worlds where they can interact and socialize with others online. There are already existing VR chat rooms and applications, and these programs allow you to change the look of your virtual avatar. Just a few weeks back, Facebook founder Mark Zuckerberg presented their plans on Metaverse. And like it or not, this move by Facebook brought a lot of eyes to the Metaverse. Facebook has been investing and experimenting on VR technology ever since they bought Oculus Rift back in 2014. Think about the movie Ready Player One. And if you haven't seen the movie, the premise is that people would use a VR device allowing them to enter a digital world. While their real bodies are in the real world, their digital avatars move freely in the vast digital world. While the current state of Metaverse VR is so far away from this movie, few existing apps and games can give somewhat a similar experience. Now that you know the Metaverse can be a futuristic hub and digital world that you can engage in, aside from the socialization aspect, you are probably wondering what it can do for you. And which is why we must talk about NFTs, or non-fungible tokens. Non-fungible means that it's unique and can't be replaced with something else. If an asset is fungible, it is replaceable. For example, a $1 note can be replaced with another $1 note. It wouldn't make a difference. A Bitcoin can be replaced with another Bitcoin. There would be no change in the value, only the ownership. And so, a non-fungible asset is the one that is irreplaceable or unique. Now on to tokens. Tokens are assets represented on a blockchain. Bitcoin is a token, so is Ethereum, Dogecoin, and other cryptocurrencies. They are all assets on a blockchain. Putting assets or tokens on a blockchain increases security and transparency. Bitcoin is a token, and so are NFTs, but they are not the same. Like I said earlier, one Bitcoin can be replaced with another Bitcoin, but NFTs cannot be replaced. They are unique. Only one person can own them, but this one person can sell the NFTs to other person. Think of NFTs like collectibles, like a grand old painting of Mona Lisa. Every token has a value for a reason. NFTs are unique. Since there is only one NFT of its kind, there is only one holder of that NFT. All kinds of artists, from digital artists to rappers, have created and sold NFTs. NFTs are basically digital art and things. Could be music, film, or JPEGs. And you buy them with cryptocurrencies. In fact, Jack Dorsey, co-founder and CEO of Twitter, sold his first tweet ever as an NFT for over $2.9 million. Now, this tweet itself will continue to live on Twitter, but the winning bidder would now own the NFT, signed and verified by the creator, like a virtual autograph. And if you're wondering what Jack did with the money, he converted the proceeds to Bitcoin and sent it to Give Directly Africa Fund. But selling tweets is not really the purpose of NFT. A lot of the conversation is about NFTs as an evolution of digital fine art collecting. For example, in this picture, her and her dad, the photographer, owned that IP and just made $5,000 selling the rights to that piece of the internet. This is Beeple's Every Day is the First 5,000 Days NFT, and it was sold for $69 million at Christie's. Now you might be wondering that all the top projects are now only accessible by the world's elite. Just like the world's most expensive paintings are hoarded by dynasty families. Well, no, because cool things like party bird exist, where you can get a group of your friends and strangers together to share the ownership of expensive NFT projects that you think will accrue in value massively. For example, this CryptoPunk hookah just sold for 61 Ethereum, split across 227 members. The percentage ownership you own is digitally recorded, and when it sells in the future, your percentage increase is obviously directly related to what you own via the smart contract. The future, after all, is community-led. This is just a great example of it in action. Which brings us back to the metaverse. The biggest companies on earth are trying to build the metaverse. Facebook, Microsoft, etc., etc., etc. So one way to think about the metaverse is that it's the online space where we exist in digital form. However you access it, via website, a gaming console, a VR headset, or a mobile app, the point is to connect up the idea as the metaverse. Why? Because people are vying for your attention, and attention equates money. Take an example of the legendary game Candy Crush. It gets you addicted to crushing candy, unlocking new levels, and constantly paying to keep going. It's pay to play. They make a game, they market it to everyone who downloads for free on their phone, and then endlessly pay for in-game tokens non-stop. More the people pay, their share price goes up, their shareholder gets rich, you get addicted, everyone is happy because this is just how the world works. This point demonstrates that people are very used to spending money in-game so long as they are enjoying it. There are games like Roblox and Fortnite where consumers pay for skins and basically upgrades that make their characters cooler. Why? Because they are all online and playing in a community with thousands of other gamers. And just like in the real world, what matters in the metaverse is the same as what matters in real life. Status, identity, cool factor, etc., etc. Where you spend your time is where advertising is valuable too. The point demonstrates that people will pay for digital upgrades and clothes that literally do nothing, but they are spending real money via their credit card to PlayStation or whoever to improve status. In the metaverse, you can be anyone you want to be. In real life, I'm a husband, dad, engineer. But in the metaverse, I can have my own pseudonym and I can be anyone I want to be and create an escapist identity for myself. For example, MeBits, they are created by the same people as the infamous CryptoPunks, a company called Larva Labs. And your MeBit is meant to be your digital identity in the metaverse. Be yourself or don't, you decide. Because in the metaverse, you can be anyone you want to be. Now, crypto always felt like it was about speculation and money, and that tends to work well for super early adopters, techies, devs, and finance folks, but not really for the masses. Art is for the masses, because it's where the culture takes off. And culture is everything, whether online or in real life, it dictates the world we live in. Crypto could be a bit dull, but art, gaming, culture, that's all fun for masses. And to play, you need crypto. So all this stuff ties up nicely together.